Episode 18, Life and Death Decisions, or Ambivalence. What the hell does that mean? Ah, here we go. Ambivalence. Noun. The state of having mixed feelings or contradictory ideas about something or someone. Sure. You know what? We'll go with that one just because I had to look it up. The episode begins, ominously enough, with Unit 3, crucified, of course, being brought to Japan. And it passes through this giant cloud that is very ominous. It's almost like there's an angel in that cloud. Is it just me, or does Shinji have a really small face here? This is why you should never freeze frame anime. Anyway, Kensuke shows up out of nowhere to beg Misato to let him become an Ava pilot. Because, you know, he knows that somebody in the school is going to become an Ava pilot, and he wants it to be him. You know, if he's wanting it, why the hell not just let him, you know? Like, Toji don't want it, we know that much, but Kensuke's sitting here begging for it. Just let the boy have it, for God's sake. It's kind of funny that Misato and Ritsuko's relationship is on the rocks now, and they're trying to act like everything's normal again by just hanging out casually. Ritsuko looking absolutely ravishing as always. But much like what happened at the Oscars, we'll never forget about that slap. See, look at Toji. He looks fucking depressed. He don't want to be an Ava pilot. Kensuke's depressed now, too. Everybody's depressed. Except Asuka, she's just pissed. She is, like, abnormally pissed. And at Toji for no real reason other than he's the next pilot. And he don't want to do it, look at him. Okay, hold on just a second here, Ray. What's going on here? Huh? Who the hell do you think you are? This might be the one and only scene where Toji and Ray actually have a conversation, you know, together with nobody else around. Oh boy. Ladies and gentlemen, I mean it. Seriously, this is the last episode where the show is positive. I'm dead serious now. At the end of this episode, you'll see. You'll see that this is all, we're at the bottom of the hill now. Roller coaster's over. I hope you enjoyed the ride. Toji's moping around about like Shinji did at the very beginning of the series after he found out that he was an Ava pilot, so that's kind of an interesting comparison between these two. I guess Toji's reaction is pretty much the same. He doesn't want to pilot an Ava either. Asuka and Hikari have a little chat about how much Hikari likes Toji, and apparently she thinks that he's cute. Back at Misato's place, Shinji and Asuka are chilling, and Shinji's like, "Hey, I wonder who the third pilot's gonna be." And Asuka's like, "Motherfucker, you don't know yet?" And he's like, "No." And Asuka's just like, "Oh, okay, well, I guess I won't tell you. Never mind. Forget about it." Which I find kind of interesting. I guess Asuka's kind of not wanting to worry Shinji because, you know, it's Toji. Oh, I forgot to mention that Kaji's also here because he's got to look after the kids because Misato's away at the moment. And he has a line here that I think's always been pretty funny for no real reason other than because I'm an idiot.
"Are you two fighting again? I don't believe it."
This is one of the few times where they weren't even actually fighting. They were just talking. That night, Shinji and Kaji have a very cool conversation. Well, it starts out with Shinji wondering what his dad's like because he notices that Kaji spends a lot of time with his father. And Kaji says, somehow it devolves into talking about women and how women always seem to be on their own kind of distant island as opposed to men. I don't know. It's some deep shit, but it's actually some pretty cool dialogue between these two. I've always liked Shinji and Kaji's chemistry. It feels like they're very similar, but very different at the same time. Oh boy. Okay, I just had a thought. So at school, Toji is gone, right? He's absent that day. And, you know, Shinji should know that today is the test, the initial run of Unit 3. Is he really not smart enough to piece together that Toji is missing that day? They need a new pilot for Unit 3, and he doesn't know who it is. But he's also gone on the same day that Unit 3 is going to be tested. He really can't put two and two together? Apparently not. Okay, anyways, Unit 3's a fucking angel now. It blows up. Here's a title card for you. What do you want from me? Oh, I know what you want. The 13th, I think. I don't know. I'm too lazy to count. Bardiel. Whatever the hell his name is. I'm pretty sure the popular theory, and probably the truth, is that the angel was inside this big old cloud whenever Unit 3 was headed to Japan, so it probably attached itself to Unit 3 as it passed through the cloud. At least that's what pretty much everybody thinks, so that's what we'll go with. So everyone gets deployed into the battlefield. They have no idea what the target is, they just think that Unit 3 is on the rampage, apparently. So Shinji's freaking out because he doesn't know who the pilot is. Asuka's berating him because he still doesn't know that it's Toji. And of course, she's about to tell him who it is when she gets cut off because apparently she gets attacked by Unit 13. Or the 13th Angel. Not Unit 13. Whatever. Rei has the 13th Angel in her sights, but it does some kind of like Jedi jump kind of bullshit. I don't know what it does here. All I know is it somehow gets the drop on her, and it starts oozing on Unit Zero's arm, and they detach it. And apparently this causes the 13th Angel to just fuck off and leave Rei alone, I guess. And of course now it's up to a reluctant Shinji who doesn't want to destroy the Angel because he knows that the pilot is still on board. And we get this cool shot, and then we get this cool shot. And then Unit 1's getting his ass handed to him, like the 13th Angel's just handing him his ass, because Shinji doesn't want to fight. So Gendo gets super pissed, and he tells Shinji to fuck off, and he's going to use the dummy system instead, the first operation with the dummy system. And this causes Unit 1 to go completely apeshit bananas. Like, I remember first watching this, I mean, obviously it was after I watched the second Rebuild movie, and the first time I seen that movie, I thought Asuka died in the part where Unit 1 goes apeshit and destroys Unit 3, but then I figured out that she was actually still alive. And I thought that the whole time that this kills Toji, but no, it doesn't. Like, my first viewing went something like this. So Toji might be dead, but, you know, don't worry, because Hikari's making him lunch, so it's okay. Misato and Ritsuko are A-okay, but, you know, we kind of already figured that they were. What the hell happened to Toji, though? Shinji's still a wreck inside Unit 1, because he blames himself for possibly murdering the pilot of Unit 3. However, he hears Misato on the radio, and she's about to tell him who he is, who the pilot was. And apparently the pilot is still alive, but barely. And before she tells him, he sees that it was Toji! Oh, the humanity! And so Shinji screams and freaks the fuck out. End of episode. What a great way to end the episode. Fantastic. So if I had to choose where exactly we were on the roller coaster at this point in time, I would say we're somewhere about here in the seventh circle of hell. It's hard to get much lower than hell, but we're gonna find a way, you know. Just this next episode. Oh boy, that's gonna be a doozy, all right. As far as this episode goes, it's the beginning of the end. And I like this episode. It's really cool. It's a good episode. I like what they do with Toji here. Unfortunately, this is pretty much the end of Toji, though. I mean, he's not dead, but he just stops being relevant. I'm gonna give it an 8.5, because why not?